Recording's a good idea.
My name.
Jim's really good at intros. You shouldn't.
Biggest tournament ever for Smash 64.
Yeah, we have a couple of those a year now, so it's
actually this, like this every tournament's the biggest ever in some way.
No, this is literally the big like the oh my god. I have a graph to prove it.
Well, I could just look at the number of attendance. That too.
Yeah, I feel like we can't hear you.
The game wrecked you? Oh, man.
All right, how about
but,
now?
But they can hear us?
Yeah, they can hear me. Oh. What was happening well, is it was...
We're talking then. All right.
Yeah,
so,
there we go.
I keep playing Tony Hawk. Rules
four stocks. Let's continue with that.
Just... yeah, just... you guys...
I can't find this fifth valve in Tony Hawk.
You guys can't impersonate me. You guys can't... There's a... I'm an impersonatable.
Well, none of us can play that poorly.
You sure you want to go there?
Just kidding, I can't.
Yeah. I was like, you could say that. You could say that now. You couldn't say that before people have actually... You know how many times I got... Whoa, you're actually good, Jim. It's like, what the fuck? Yeah, why would I be... I've been playing this game.
From the Midwest, it's like the Shears effect. You know, like nobody likes you, so they expect you to be bad.
Wow, please, come on now.
That's wow.
Wow. That is the meanest thing you've ever said to me. You've never said anything... That has ever made me feel bad, but I don't feel good after you just said that to me. Oh,
good old
Jesus.
Shears effect.
All right.
All right, so SmashCon, what are we talking about with that?
Yeah, thank you. So, how about we talk about how many Falcons you guys gave me? I really appreciate that. Whoever.
Wait, can people hear you now?
Yeah, people can hear me.
Oh, okay.
I fixed it. Yeah, I got a face Falcon. It was sick.
Nice. And Alvin got to face Yoshi.
Yeah.
That just happened for some people. They just like played one character.
I just blame Shears.
Wait, what happened with Shears?
Just blame him.
Nothing. You just blame him for anything tournament like related. Yeah.
Praise him.
Or that.
So one. That's good. It's the best thing Shears has ever done in his life.
But no, I think Smash the cool SmashCon was cool. Like the upsets. My God. Can we just like go over some of them?
Yeah.
There were just too many.
Yeah, who's the number one upset for you?
Taco's losing to Court, and Taco's losing to the Z, and Alvin losing to Japan.
Okay, I was about to say, like, we're not going to mention Alvin. People were like, he might take the whole thing. And it's like, we got 17th place. Like, that's rough, dude. It's not a good
look.
He
essentially lost the same matchup twice.
Yeah.
Like, that's rough.
But, I mean, now it's like, I feel like TOs in every region have a responsibility to start playing Yoshi. Because you can't have your region losing to Yoshis.
Yeah, good thing we have a Yoshi over here.
Yeah, Shears does that.
As long as you got a good Kirby. Yeah.
Between you or
the,
between...
The fourth best Yoshi, right, in the country?
You have Shears?
Yeah.
No, Bacorn plays Yoshi now, so Shears is fifth best Yoshi in the country.
It just cracks me up. Shears beats people with Yoshi.
He beat me with Yoshi.
Yeah, exactly. It's hilarious.
He shouldn't have beat. I beat myself. That was really bad. If you watched that set, you would have been like, Jim, stop doing the same thing over and over and losing.
How'd you do, Jim, at SmashCon?
SmashCon? I got 33rd. One for each one of my dollar signs.
All tied with me. Tied with me.
That means you made it. Into bracket and then won two matches.
One match. I beat Jason from Brazil in bracket.
Another Falcon.
Did you get all Fox?
Yeah, I don't have any characters that aren't Fox.
Nice. Who'd you beat?
I beat someone.
Yeah, I heard you beat an Arizona player.
Oh, Freyan?
Yeah.
I beat Freyan.
Another Falcon.
Did you see that?
I felt bad for Freyan. I felt bad for him.
Were you watching that?
Yeah, I was watching it. Dude, I was on the setup next to you. I was just like, dude, he just keeps getting lasered. And
he doesn't know how to play the matchup.
did he try Luigi?
No. I didn't know he had a Luigi.
That's what I thought he'd go.
Okay. So here's what I knew about Freyan going in. This was before Smash, like when I got my pools. I was like, okay, so my pool is Bonobono, Clubadubba, Freyan, and Snorlax. Those are the four people that are seated. Yeah. So I lose to Snorlax, and then I go into like zone in mode, like don't even talk to me. I don't know anything about anyone. Like, so someone sits down and plays, they're like, oh, this is who you're playing. I'm like, okay, cool. Sit down and play that guy, beat him. Don't know who it was. Next person sits down. They're like, are you Jim? I'm like, yep. And he's like, all right, I'm playing you. Sit down, beat him. Don't know who it was. I'm like, all right, who's my next person? I go up to the TO and he's like, oh no, you're done for the day. You got out of pools. So that second one was Freyan. I didn't know it was him at all. So
it's just funny because his training partner is a Fox main. So
yeah, that's what I was going to say.
What? What does his training partner do?
Dubs. He's a really good Fox player.
He is.
Yeah.
What is he? Dude, he needs to get with me. I can teach him how to play the matchup, man.
Apparently, he just doesn't laser enough. That's all you got to do.
You got a laser, camp, and you have to have your edge guards, man. You have to have your edge guards, your tech chases, your combos. My punish game on Falcon.
Well, I was surprised he didn't go Luigi even game two, let alone game one. I feel like his Luigi is even Luigi's better good. Than his Falcon, yeah.
Yeah.
But you just run away from Luigi. Yeah. That's all you have to do. Right.
You're especially when when you're in the zone and you're like, I'm going to win. I don't care at all. Like, yeah, I'm going to run away from a Luigi and laser him. I don't care. Hit him with a back air. I don't care. You're not going to grab me.
Yeah. That's pretty cool. Another match. Did Revan play Bonobono or Corrado?
Yeah. He messed
Revan,
him up.
Revan 5-stocked Bonobono.
5-stocked him. I could not believe that. I was watching and I was like, how is this even possible?
Well, I mean, we already know Revan does well against Yoshi after the last time.
Yeah, but I didn't know he was going to do that well. Like, yeah, that was absurd.
That's,
he's the Yoshi Slayer. The King of the North!
King of the North. He is in the North. He's in Canada.
Yeah. Yeah, he's the Kirby King of the North. So I thought that was really cool. I think North America really did well. And by North America, I guess USA is kind of piggybacking on Canada's back on that one. But still, North America.
What? Hold on. U.S. had Isaiah and Wizrobe.
Yeah.
Ooh.
U.S. had two of the top three.
Yeah, we did.
Wizzy turned it up, man.
Yeah, he did. Wizrobe was certainly helped by his bracket.
Yeah.
And by certainly, I mean by a lot. But he's, like, obviously a very good player. He did still beat the Z, right? Yeah.
Like, think about how many players he would have run into that he typically loses to.
Right. Like, I mean,
Tacos, Kiro. Like, Kiro.
Tacos, Kiro, I think he would have lost to Mariguas, and he could have lost to Dexter. Basically, the Pikachus. He could have lost to Revan if he had played Revan.
He would have lost to Revan if he played Revan.
Against most of the top 8 cast, like, could have beaten him, but he ran into the Z, and then, boom, and Isaiah.
Yeah. So, I mean, the U.S. did well. Mexico did well. And, all four of those regions were in the top 8.
Yeah, we did good.
What about Dexter's loss, man? That was heartbreaking.
Ooh, Dexter at one car.
That was like the most when that happened.
Easily either the number one or the number two most exciting moment of the tournament.
Yeah, I mean, it not only in the fashion that he lost in, it's just he was right on the cusp of top 8. That's kind of what makes it sting more.
For people that didn't see it, what happened?
Dude, it was game 5 with him and Wangera, and he was up a few percent.
And who? And what happens if you win?
I think he was up 6%.
Yeah, he was up a few percent with the time about to run out, and with, I believe, 5 seconds left, Wangera got a hit and ran away and won.
He got him with a neutral air, I think.
I think it was a weak one.
Yeah, it was like a weak neutral air, and he was just like, boop, and then he just with immediately like just jumped
left.
Away.
Took
yeah,
off.
6 seconds left.
He's just doing rising.
This is
like, oh, man.
This is great. So I got to see this, and this was playing in whoever loses gets ninth. So you win, you get into top eight.
Yep.
Lose,
yep.
Nobody cares. And I remember,
game 5.
Yeah, and I was talking to Dexter about it like a day later, and it was kind of how he was playing, because he wasn't playing like, I want to time you out. He was just like, this guy has to approach me. And he was like making Wangera do like really risky, like neutral game kind of things. Not like teleport, whatever, but, you know, going in when you wouldn't. And then that entirely goes off and it eventually pays off.
He wasn't running away enough.
Yeah. You guys should have seen the H-box pop off, though. It was pretty good.
Yeah, well,
He like ran across the room. He was so sad that at one point Wangera missed a rest, and you could tell Hungrybox was just sad watching that Jigglypuff get pushed off the edge and die.
Oh yeah, he didn't know about that. That was pretty funny.
It was really. I really enjoyed watching H-box during Wangera's games.
Yeah, that was pretty good. I guess another thing to cover about SmashCon, Colorado just.
I told you guys. Did I tell you guys?
Yeah.
Did I tell
now,
you
was
guys?
Was it Colorado in general, or was it just D-Tan?
No, it was D-Tan, Satan, or God, whatever he was going by.
Dude, that's so funny that he's... I talked to Jacob. Jacob's like...
And then Dog also.
Yeah. Okay, so Jacob is the number one PR in Colorado. He flew in... I think he got in like an hour and a half before his bracket started. Not like as a Johns, because he still did well, and he still... like his mistakes were his own mistakes, but... I think it was good that he performed that well, considering all that. But I think it's really funny that he's gone by like 5 different tags, and his current one is Satan, like Satan, but I'm pretty sure it's just a parody of D-Tan.
Yeah.
And then God is another guy, which is just going off of Satan, which is just going off of D-Tan. So I don't know what's going on in Colorado, but I told you guys, Colorado's the bomb. D-Tan. Yeah. Do you want to tell it? Do you want me to tell it? Let me tell it.
You tell it. Someone tell it.
I sit down. I'm playing. I think I play again. It doesn't matter. I'm finishing up in tournament, and I play my game, and I finish it, and I look over, and I see a monster crowd. And I'm like, who is – it's not like in front of a projector. It's just in front of a TV. And I'm like, who on earth is playing that – why is there a crowd? Because it's not even on, like, the stream setup. And I look over – can't really see, and then I see D-Tan's face, and I jump up, I leave my controller where it was, because in my mind I'm like, I don't know who D-Tan is playing, but he just took a game off of him, and it's somebody he shouldn't beat. And I like get up, and I see, and it's D-Tan Isaiah.
Yeah.
And Isaiah's going Pika against his Kirby, and I'm like, he took a game off Isaiah. Ooh. That's right. That's let's go.
That was pretty good.
Isaiah went Fox, right?
Yeah, he got. Do you want me to take credit for? I don't want to take credit for that, but I did play a week's worth of Fox against D-Tan.
I was playing friendlies against D-Tan that Friday night. I beat him the first 4 or 5 games out of like 30. Yeah. Yoshi. I thought he would make it a lot farther in bracket, and I'm surprised he didn't. I did not expect to outplace D-Tan.
He's so good.
Yeah, he's really good.
How do you lose? I know Cord also took down like Tacos right afterwards, but like.
Yeah.
That's a takeaway from Cord, but D-Tan like under other circumstances could have done some huge damage.
I think a problem with that is that Satan plays Link, but he doesn't. Play that runaway style of Link that Court played against him, so he wasn't ready for that. So I found I saw him struggling a lot to deal with Court's projectiles.
Court beat him with Link.
Yeah. I think if Court went Pikachu, Court would have lost to D-Tan. Not as a shot against Court, but D-Tan and Dog are brothers. Dog plays Pika. Like D-Tan, it's a good match. Like it's a matchup that he knows. more so than I think Corden is.
The Colorado guys, anyways, they got to make it out to more tournaments. They got to.
Yeah.
They're coming out to Boss Battle.
It was really funny, though, because Mad Rush was telling me about them, and he's like, yeah, we got a Satan guy, and he's, like, super cocky. Dude. Like, he keeps telling Mad Rush, like, he said, I don't know how we aren't the best people in the world. And, like, he kept telling Mad Rush that, and Mad Rush was like, okay, hopefully we're going to go out to the tournament and just get destroyed. And then they did really good, so it's, like, not helping his ego at all.
Dude, all
so
of them
like,
are
I
so...
I told you, Mad Rush, we are the best people in the world.
Okay, so...
I thought that was pretty funny.
So Satan, Jacob, he types capital L, lowercase OL, exclamation point. Like, he leaves comments that are that. That's the best way that I can describe Jacob, is he's always like, yeah, man. Like, he just loves that. He's like, yo, did you see that thing that Isaiah did? Like it's his first time watching Isaiah, but every single time that he does it. So I love Jacob. I think Jacob's a bomb. But what was great is that back in the beginning, in, like, January, Jacob makes a post that's like, hey, do you guys have any videos? Like, I need help with the Kirby matchup. I'm having some issues with it. Do any of you guys have any suggestions or any videos to watch? This guy's, but they need to be good Kirby's because the Kirby I'm playing is really good. He's like right under Kakoshi.
Yep.
Oh my god.
And everyone's like, dude, who is this guy? Like, dude,
so
you're a clown.
The screenshot of right under Kakoshi.
Yeah. So everyone makes fun of him for the longest time. Like, this whole thread, like, is a really long thread for something that I didn't even pay attention to. But it's a huge thing in Colorado to, like, make fun of Jacob for being, like, yeah, right under Kakoshi or whatever. And then they come out and T-Tan's, like, actually really, really good.
Yeah, it was just funny because he's like, see? I told you guys. We are the best in the world.
Yeah, dude, I told you. Dude, I've been...
It was hilarious.
Have I not been... I've told you guys how good Colorado is for how long? How long did you guys not believe me?
They're pretty good. So I'll have to play out there more often.
Shame on you guys.
Are they coming to Boss Battle?
Yeah, Boss Battle 2.
Oh, boy.
They're going. I'm going. Boy. It's going to be sick.
It's going to be a stacked tournament.
Yeah. Oh, I'm so excited. Yeah, who else went far? So, like, all those people got 30. Actually, one last thing about the Colorado boys. Jacob and D-Tan both got 33rd. Dog, who every time that I play Dog in tournament, he double four stocks me. Like, Dog just destroys my Fox. Absolutely destroys him. But I was at a Colorado tournament right before, and he destroyed me in bracket. Keep on going. Zantetsu beats him, and then I face Zantetsu and beat Zantetsu. So I end up outplacing Dog. And then at SmashCon, Dog is like 49th, so I outplaced him again. So every time he destroys, like, he's like, in the head-to-head, I have no chance against him. But in bracket,
so
I always outplace
him. So it is me
and Soto. Yeah.
So it is. I always outplace him.
So I, who was it that, I forget who, oh, Moonshoes. Moonshoes had like a N64 for everyone to sign that got into top 64.
Mm-hmm.
And I made Dog sign his name right under mine because he always places right beneath me.
Oh,
that's funny. Yeah. But, and then who are the other? Zero had a really good win.
Oh yeah, he did.
I thought that was pretty good because he hasn't really come out to a ton of tournaments. So.
Stranded drew well. Also, he got ninth.
Yeah. Stranded did well. Stranded's
he tied Kira.
Yes, he did. He's better than Kiro this year because he won a major and Kiro hasn't. So.
Oh my god.
And then he tied with him at the biggest tournament ever.
We can't call Apex a major.
Like, why? He's trying to beat to get ninth.
Apex is. I can find out probably.
I don't remember who he beat.
He must have been somebody good to get ninth.
And he really threw that game away against.
Wait, did he play court?
Yeah,
he played Corwin. Corwin all linked against him for whatever reason. Yeah. I don't understand.
Oh, and he beat Jaime. Strain to beat Jaime. Send your patience.
And he lost to Wangera, it looks like.
Yeah, he really, he kind of threw that one away.
Oh, Revan. Revan beat Strain. Okay.
Yeah, that's pretty cool, though.
Oh, that was really close, I think. Revan stranded.
Really?
Wasn't it, like, back and forth?
That was a massacre.
Oh, I thought it was, like, back and forth.
That was a 3-0.
It was 3-1.
Really? Okay. I didn't know Stranded 3 game.
The most lopsided 3-1.
So Revan got his revenge because he lost to Stranded last year at SmashCon.
Yeah, as a rematch.
Oh. I think it's really.
I know Revan ended one of the games with the up B spike because it was like as soon as I walked away, like the whole crowd just went crazy and I was like.
I think I remember seeing it, and Revan had like a small little smirk on his face. Just like that. he gets that small little smirk whenever he like does something cool. He's just like. He's just like super humble too, but it's just funny.
I had the weirdest conversation with Revan. Javier already knows. you weren't even at the conversation that I was with, and you're already like, yeah, I've had weird conversations. I bring D10 over to talk to Revan. I'm like, yo, you should see if Revan has any tips for you. And Revan apparently is like super tired at this point, but he's just like, he basically just goes like, yo, so you just want to like, basically, you just, people have all these specifics, but you want to like generalize things. So like, what you should do is be like, all right, so you have like up tilt and like pivot up tilt. So that's great. But like, just think of that as an up air or anti air. So let's just generalize it. You have that. Then you can do like jump offsets and do all this. And, and like he starts going through this, and we're like, wait, what's a jump offset? And he's like, yeah, so you'd like do that, you just generalize it, then you like have a situation to specify it. And we're like, no, Revan, what's a jump offset? And like we finally get him to define what he means by jump offset, which is like you jump where you're at and then you like down air the spot that you're at. And D-Tan just like, so like spacing.
I can just imagine those two having a conversation.
Dude, it's so great. They just like play so. I think they think about the game in entirely opposite ways. Of just like, I just space against people. Like that's what you do to win, and that's like what D10 says. And Revan's like, I have all these theoretical ideas. So I love that.
Good God.
Oh. It's like this picture, right?
What is this picture? Oh, the Falcon Punch picture. Yeah, let me see if I can pull this up for everyone.
That's a pretty good picture description. Dude,
that is exactly that's exactly D-Tan versus Revan.
Oh. That's funny.
I had a great so I was everywhere that I went, so I went on this huge ass trip, right? Everywhere that I went I asked people, do you think you play similar to how you talk to people or like how you communicate or how you act? And I explained this to the Colorado boys, and they're like, what do you, cause I started laughing cause I think they play exactly how they act. They're always like having like little jabs at each other, but like super safe jabs that they don't. They're always like, dude, careful when you're backing up, you're gonna hit the curb. He's like, dude, I'm not gonna hit the curb. He's like, dude, you're definitely gonna hit the curb. And then like they don't hit the curb, and then they just totally forget about the entire interaction. Like super emotional interactions that just like, and so I start laughing. I'm like, you guys are always bickering about like random things, and they're like, dude, that we're not bickering, dude, what are you talking about, we're not bickering.
That's like you're basically describing Shears except for the last part.
Yeah. What, forgetting about things or
like everything gets like really like blown up and everything and arguing.
No.
And then it's over.
Theirs are just like their expression, like how they express their opinions is just very emotional and like animated. So it was really good. So I don't know.
Before Shears moves to Colorado. Oh,
Jesus
Christ. Yeah. I couldn't imagine.
Dude, that wouldn't be good. Shears wouldn't fit in with Colorado, I don't think.
Then Colorado could learn Yoshi.
Yeah, right. they really need a Yoshi. They didn't face one, did they? Do you guys know if they faced one?
I have no clue.
Satan lost to Salt. D-Tan lost to Court. I don't know. Oh, I think Satan might have lost to like Prince or someone like that. Oh, he lost to Prince. That's who he lost to.
Yeah.
And of course, he's like smiling. He's like, oh, I could have beaten
that
them.
That was a great set too. Prince Mariguas.
What happened?
Prince Mariguas is just a really good set.
Oh yeah,
that Mariguas. Was,
did that come into the fourth or fifth game?
I'm not sure. I thought it was five.
Yeah, I think it might have been five.
And dude, Prince had that crazy egg edge guard.
Oh, yeah, where it hit him and knocked him back off stage. And then he killed him.
Oh, I remember that.
That was a cool Yeah, Prince was holding the ledge while Marugos was recovering, and then he just kind of jumped off and threw an egg at the top platform, and he had hit Marugos back off stage, and then he just jumped and forward aired him or back aired him or something. Yeah. It was awesome.
Yeah, SmashCon was a good tournament. I had fun.
I think
was no YOLO tournament, but it's okay.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I forgot about it. I just like completely forgot about it.
Yeah. But ODS YOLO tournament.
Yes. Of course.
So is some guy that no one's ever heard of gonna show up and win? Like shine?
Probably. Yeah, it's gonna be nutty. I'm excited. There's a shit ton to do, but it'll all be worth it, I'm sure.
What is ODS?
Tell us about it.
Yeah, it's the second time around that we're doing it. It's a tournament at my house in Arizona. Last year was 30-some people, you know, Boom, Tacos, Jaime, a lot of top players. This year it's even more stacked. I mean, it's gonna be nuts. Stranded, Kiro, Revan, Fireblaster, I mean, the list goes on.
Derek?
You know?
Derek.
The legend. There, so
Derek's
that's his.
Joy?
Derek is going.
Yeah, Derek's going. So.
Is Isaiah going?
No, he. I offered. I thought he was
for. Like I thought
he,
really.
He told
recently.
Me it was something work related.
Oh, that's
too
bad.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah, but what do you need Isaiah for if Derek's going?
Yeah.
He's just gonna give the grand finals to Wizrobe anyways.
And I think it's gonna be what his second time he's ever played in tournament, Derek. So It'll be good, and especially because there's gonna be a bunch of people here that he played at Gommel. So Hopefully we'll see some rematches.
Is the Z going to ODS?
No, he couldn't as well. So we're missing.
I want to see that rematch.
Yeah, that would have been a good one. I'm sure he'll go to more tournaments now. I mean, he seems to. After Gommel, I don't think he can get out of the scene at this point.
No, he's been immortalized.
Yeah.
He has a statement after him. Come on.
And he needs revenge against Wispy.
Yep.
Wait, what happened with Wispy?
Dude, that's the only... Wispy is the only reason that Derek didn't beat the Z.
What?
He had Z off stage, and all he had to do was stand there and edge guard. Because Z was so far away that, like, there was nothing else that he could do. And while he's crouching there waiting to up tilt, Wispy blew him off stage, and then Z got back, and then Z came back and won.
Ruined it. Yep.
So,
yeah.
Would you guys be, as a quick tangent, would you guys be, assuming that, like, in the next version of 19XX, we get stage toggles off or stage hazards off, would you guys be in favor of removing wind?
No, I kind of like it.
You cannot take that off. As much as I want random factors to be removed, you can't remove such an important factor of the game.
And if you get rid of the wind, how am I going to do all those taunt cancels?
Exactly. Yeah. I don't think taunt cancel that much.
All right,
fishing
sorry.
Fishing rod taunt cancels wouldn't exist.
And, like, with the wind and everything, you can see it coming. You can hear it coming before like it actually starts pushing you. I'm pretty sure you can even hear it.
It's the more important part of the people's gameplay than it seems. Like, it forces Jigglypuff to fight on the right side of the stage. It forces, like, certain characters to favor the left side, and it just creates a different dynamic that would just disappear if you took away the wind, which is not entirely random, so...
Like, I don't know about you guys, but if I'm going to edgeguard someone, I will not go all the way up to the edge and crouch and down tilt. I'll, like, stay back a tiny bit.
On the right side, I will. But on the left side, you kind of, like...
Stay like a little bit off. Because all it's going to take a little bit of wind and I just fastball down here and die. Like,
And Wispy would be there looking like a dumbass. I mean, he never.
What's your purpose?
I mean, what are you going to do to the face?
Wispy, what is your profession?
Or what you can do is do the opposite code that exists. That does exist, but Wispy's constantly blowing.
Oh. What if Wispy was constantly blowing in both directions?
I don't like that at all. You know, some of us depend on laser camping.
But if you once you clank with Kirby, then it pushes him off. So then,
Curry goes to the center of the stage and just starts self filming.
All right, all right. Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm sorry that we got on such a tangent, dude.
It's all your fault.
Dude, my bad, guys. So
I was curious about ODS. Are we, are we doing like side tournaments or are we doing like round robin pools?
I didn't hear
anything about that. Oh, pool basketball. Oh yeah. You know that's going on.
Wait. Yeah. Yeah. There's gonna be so much side shit. I feel like the tournament is just like 20% of the weekend, and damn. I mean, we gotta drive. The closest airport is 2 hours away, and it's Vegas. We have to pick up 15 people, so that shows how much like out of
it's
town.
It's only 2 hours away? I thought it was longer.
Yeah, it's 2 hours, but it's a terrible 2 hours. I mean. And
so it is. It's just 2 hours in the desert. There's nothing there.
Same road. Like getting like a bus, a minibus or something.
Yeah, that's what we did. Yeah, we got like a van that just holds 15. So I mean,
is your homie driving everyone again?
No, different guy. Yeah,
it's I just heard one dude just like driving everybody.
Yeah, and he didn't even. Playing the tournament, he has nothing to do with Smash Bros. He just was the ultimate homie and helped out. But this year is gonna be nuts. I mean, it's twice as packed. However, room is gonna be, yeah, room is gonna be double. Put it that way. There's and I keep my house bitter cold. And last year with all the bodies and all the setups. It didn't get as cold as I want, so we're kind of managing the room a little bit better. Plus the pool, it's gonna be, I mean, at least 110, I would think. Pool's always the main attraction. This year, I was a little smarter and I had everyone sign a waiver. That way, it pretty much said if you're a dumbass and you jump off the roof into the pool and break your neck, that's your fault. You know,
what about if you're Revan and you fall asleep outside and then you burn to a crisp like a vampire?
I literally open my blinds to my slider at like 9 a.m. and I see the man in his black trench coat, you know, sitting in a chair in the 100 degree by 9 o'clock, 100 degrees sun, just baking out there, sound asleep, just baking.
He's a Canadian, he should have died.
Yeah, so it's, and I...
He could have. Or that one dude, like, passed out outside?
Yeah, well, I keep...
I think Hero Pie passed out outside.
Snosa. I saw that dude at Snosa. It was these kids from Bakersfield, and one of them had
Bakersfield.
This hellish weekend. He drank too much the first night, and this... I wish somebody, like, documented this dude's weekend, because it was such a hellish weekend. He fell asleep out by, like, the hammock and the rocks, and was puking all night, and then probably about an hour before tournament, it was looking like he needed to go home, and Bakersfield is a long way from Havasu. So I said, are you all right? Are you going to be able to play in tournament? The man is face down, the sun's up, and come tournament time, the man jumped in the pool, was in here, fresh as a day, like says, I'm perfect, feel great, took a dip in the pool, played his tournament matches, probably went 0-2, and then right after the tournament, was straight out in the rocks again, face down. And I looked at his friends, I'm like, you might need to take your bro home, he is just not doing good, but... someone from LA too. What was it? Was it Dez?
I think it was Hero. Oh, Dez like died.
Yeah, he had a rough time too.
Yeah, that's all because of me and Soto probably. But it's okay.
The tequila doubles.
Yeah.
The first
doubles was fun. It was good.
Doubles is always fun.
Yeah, that's even better. That's kind of like what we kind of envision ODS to be. It's not necessarily a major. As much as it is a smash retreat and a party, you can't take the tournament too serious when everyone's running around half naked in the pool, you know? So,
of course. So Stranded would love it.
Yeah, oh, I'm sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
There's no gumball machine there, though.
Yeah.
Hold on.
Right. I know you got like a YOLO tournament. Are we doing round robin pools? Or what are we doing for that?
It'll probably be bracket pools. Yeah, okay. It'll probably be bracket pools, pool basketball. I got some friends of mine that are trying to box. There's UFC that night.
Yeah, Bard. I think Bard's going to box, by the way. So
no shit.
Heads up. And it was just really funny because I was like, oh, yeah, you box. He's like, yeah, I box exactly like how I play Smash. And he kind of like
he's going to time you out.
He's going to do like pivot jabs. Like,
that's dude, my hero.
Yeah, it'll be good. Yeah, it'll be, yeah, I know I have some friends that don't want to box. That'll be somewhat entertaining if they're a bit inebriated. But there's a huge boxing fight on that night. I mean, it's just, it's pretty much going to be a party. You guys were there last night, last night.
And we got a women's bracket, too.
Yeah.
Are you serious?
We'll be offering a women's bracket, so it'll be cool. My girlfriend's been trading up, so. Yeah. Watch out.
Just get the Colorado brothers.
Sexist.
There's a few more, though, that are...
She just caught a lot of crap for trying that one time.
For what?
And then, a few months later, Smash Sisters was a thing.
Oh, women's bracket?
Yeah, we were going to have one in a tournament, and people, started flipping out.
Dude, people do...
They're like, why? Why is there one just for women? Like, what? Like, why
Because they
not?
Want to.
Like, yeah, they want to?
Like, yeah.
Like, it's not like they can't play in the other bracket.
There's no reason that you...
Yeah. It was ridiculous. It was just, Reddit hating Shears more.
Yeah.
Though, to be fair, Shears is such a jerk on Reddit. Alright,
Shears is funny. He's hilarious.
I just hope somebody doesn't die. Literally, that's all I'm hoping for.
I don't think
that's on my watch.
That's how you know it's a good tournament.
That's a good,
if that's the standard, I think you're going to exceed it very well. I think we'll be okay. Right.
Yeah, nobody gets, seriously hurt. Last year, it was, 5 a.m., people were jumping off into the roof, into the three-foot section of the pool, mind you. And I told Aces, I'm like, yo, I'm going to sleep. You handle. Nobody else jump off the roof. I get in bed and I hear footsteps on the roof 10 minutes later. Yeah, and I'm like, this motherfucker. But yeah, you got it. I believe it or not, that while we're on the subject of that stranded picture, my friend actually found that on a clickbaited article.
What is the picture? I don't know what the picture is.
Swear to God, and found it, and he goes, dude, this looks like Stranded. He sent it to Shears. Oh. Shears goes, bro, how did you get that? Did you Photoshop that? That is actually him. Are you a hacker? And I'm like, no, that is just a so spot-on doppelganger that it had to be him. That was the only explanation. And it turned out
it was Court?
To be him.
Oh.
Yeah. Which was the craziest thing.
Yeah, he was in some article. It was
what's the picture?
Wait, is him?
Yeah, was him.
Yeah, he's him.
No, hold on.
Yes. He was at some party and there's a gumball machine and he did that. And I think he was wearing it was an ABC party.
Yeah.
So that's why he had the lemons taped over his nipples or whatever.
What is the picture?
But there oh god.
Can somebody send it to me, please, or describe it? Please just describe it. Actually, I don't need to see it.
Describing it doesn't do justice.
Yeah, there's really no point.
Hold on, I'll see if I have it anywhere.
Oh, you gotta show the picture.
What is the picture?
It's one of the greatest pictures.
How do I not know about this?
No.
Javi, you don't like this picture?
You would never want to get out, and I think he intended for it to get out.
That's how Stranded is, though.
There was some article, though. It was like college kids going against their parents, or some party picture.
Yeah.
And he was in the top 10 of it, and I was like, what?
So I will say, before I've seen this picture, that I don't believe that it's a true Stranded picture unless there is a shirtless man in it.
Well, he's shirtless.
It's a Stranded picture, then.
He's shirtless with lemons taped over his nipples.
And he's straight ass, dude. I swear to on a gumball machine with a dog in the background, let me out.
Dude, I definitely want to see this picture now.
Hold on, I'm searching.
Dude, I was I visited the Spazoli's before SmashCon, and Stranded tried to get me to take a picture with him shirtless. I was like, dude, come on now. Did you say nice? Yeah, nice, dude.
Yeah, I said nice. Do you do it?
No.
Why not?
I don't want any part of that. There's no part of that that I want. Are you guys going to send me this picture or what?
Yeah. I'm looking. It's deep into my photos, I'm sure.
Yeah. All right, boys. I got to get...
Wait, so when's ODS? Tell us.
It's next weekend. Uh-huh. So Thursday night is pretty much when everyone comes in, including Fireblasted, all the people flying in. And then Friday night, everyone will come in that's driving, and the stream will be up all weekend, I'm sure. And then the tournament in its entirety, doubles, singles, everything, salty sweet, is Saturday night, and I'm still playing Smurf for 500 bones in my fedora, so that's Saturday night.
Dang. And it's being streamed? Or is it being streamed?
All of it. The whole weekend, I'm sure the stream will never go down. So,
what's the stream?
Twitch.tv/TheMrDaniels.
Cool.
So, alright, that's Saturday. I'll see you guys. Make sure to tune in to our next weekend. It'll be good.
Dude, awesome. Thanks for hanging out, dude.
Alright, thanks for having me. I'll see you guys.
See ya.
See you soon, man.
So I have a Facebook message from Alex Jungston.
You're gonna wish and see it.
You can't unsee it.
Why is he entirely naked? I thought he was just shirtless.
We don't know. We haven't figured this out yet.
What does Tommy said about this? Actually, no, I don't want to know. What does Joey say about this?
I don't know. We should post on 64 Hell and ask him.
You guys do that. I'm not a part of 64 Hell.
I'm good. I'll pass.
Joey, explain your brother. Oh my god.
Yeah. Yeah. ODS is gonna be cool. That's the good news.
So that's if you notice on our agenda, it says SmashCon, ODS, and then who even knows? We planned for this.
Know? How long can we talk about one person that knows?
No, I'm saying that's what that was. That picture was who even knows.
Yeah.
That's the only way to describe what I just saw there.
All right, good night, everybody.
I could make a mention this Wednesday, SoCal, we're going to have our weekly.
Don't play me local.
Revan's flying into L.A. Early. Mark Sanchez is flying down into L.A. early. And I think Jimmy Joe, I think, is also planning on doing it. So we're going to have our entire PR plus them.
That's pretty good.
Pretty cool.
So that's to the level of a Colorado local.
No, not at all. Way above that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so... It's all right. It's good.
No, that'd be sick.
Yeah, it should be fun.
That'd be sick. Let's talk a little bit more about SmashCon while I have you guys. How'd you guys do?
Dude, can we talk about the combo contest?
Yeah, combo contest.
Yeah, that was cool.
All right, next up. Next year's.
I think janitor
do you think
has
another
the
event. Will try it. Do you think another tournament will try and do one?
I hope they don't.
Because it is a whole year away, so I don't know. Or if another event will try something similar, to have a new special event.
Yeah. I wouldn't like to see it more than maybe twice a year.
Yeah.
Once a year would be really nice, but if Genesis wanted to do it or whatever our...
I think that's what we're planning on. I talked to them already.
That'd be cool. Is Genesis going to be as sick as last year?
It's going to probably be sicker.
It should be, yeah.
So, I think it'll probably get more attendance than SmashCon this year.
No way.
I think
no
so.
Way you're
the,
no,
the
yeah, North, no. No,
NorCal
that's really good.
Is just like NorCal. Well, yeah, it's the biggest tournament, but there wasn't that big of a representation from NorCal last year. And the NorCal scene has just exploded. Everyone's a scrub. Sorry, NorCal. But they just get like a ton of it. Like they have like weeklies with like 30 people now. It's stupid.
That's pretty good.
Oh.
Yeah. But
are they at the foundry?
Like, you know, there's always that question like, would you rather fight a horse-sized duck or like 100 horse or duck-sized horses? It's like NorCal is like, there's a lot of them, but they're really little. They can overwhelm you.
So I think it'll at least be close to SmashCon size, if not bigger.
It all depends on which international players we can get.
Yeah, like, and they expressed a lot of like interest in including Wario and like the international player fund and everything.
Yeah.
Alvin obviously would be able to go just because he has his visa now. So we'd be able to see Wario versus Alvin if Alvin's even able to make it that far.
Yeah, I see. We had what, 4 guys from Japan come to SmashCon?
Yeah.
We could see that, if not more, come to Genesis, just because...
And it's cheaper.
It's easier for them to get there, right?
Yeah, and it's way cheaper. Coast. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I mean. So,
yeah.
Like, yeah, Genesis could be just as big or bigger than SmashCon.
We're going to have the three biggest tournaments in 1 year. It's usually just one.
Well, also, you have scenes like Australia and... Europe,
yeah,
the scene,
is getting bigger
where
now,
like
yeah.
They're not going to come over here more than once a year, so like Genesis is going to be that one time.
Yep.
Do you think they're going to come out again? I mean, it is their Christmas.
To be fair, they're either going to come to Genesis or they're going to wait till next SmashCon. So it's hard.
I was talking to Simeon, and he was talking about like after SmashCon, he was like, "Oh, I got to go out to a tournament, man! I really got to go out to a tournament." He's like, "What should I go out to?" I'm like, "Look. If you're going to go out to one tournament, SmashCon seems to be our biggest each year." He's like, "Yeah, but Genesis is sooner. Maybe I should just go out to Genesis." So I was like,
"Yeah,
that's
the thing. It's like when once the like top players get confirmed for Genesis, it's going to be really hard to say, well, I could wait for SmashCon."
Yeah. And like Isaiah literally lives 5 minutes from the Genesis venue.
Yeah, he can just walk there, I think.
Yeah, he could literally walk there. But, I mean, the Genesis venue's sick. I mean, the top 8 venue, like...
Yeah, it's its own
stadium.
Yeah,
it's a separate venue.
If they make enough money to continue doing it.
It's a concert hall.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, then Genesis is just going to get bigger. So I've been talking to them already about some stuff.
You have to buy tickets to the watch the top 8 in person, right?
You're going to have to, because it's going to be bigger than last year, and they were, you know, they ran out of space last year.
Yeah, and they're also getting a bigger ballroom.
Wait, so if you go to Genesis...
Where that volleyball tournament was, they got that space now.
Okay, so Jim, Genesis, there's like a convention center.
Yeah, yeah, I'm aware of the setup. It's like across the street.
Yeah, but for top 8, for Sunday, there are going to be so many more people this year that the concert hall is going to be like totally sold out.
Yeah, they wouldn't be able to fit everyone in the concert hall.
So you have to buy Genesis tickets and top 8 tickets.
Still being sold?
I don't know how it works exactly.
Yeah, I don't even know if they started selling it yet, or maybe they have.
I think they have. I saw something about it on Twitter.
Yeah, I haven't talked to them a ton about like the details for Genesis, but they're prepping for it to be like significantly better than last year, and last year was like stupid.
And a lot of people are gonna be like, "Oh, I don't feel like buying." Like, how much is it? How much is it to watch top 8 in person?
I can check right now. Yeah. I haven't bought mine yet because I wasn't sure if I was going, so.
Because you're gonna make top 8, so you don't need to buy a ticket.
That's right.
Yeah, what happens if you make top 8?
I'm sure a lot of people are gonna be like, "Oh, I could just watch it in the hotel room or whatever." But dude, it's not the same. Like, that's you're in this huge concert hall.
It was so
hype. Like,
it was insane.
It was
so
really
hype.
Cool.
Yeah.
Shit. It's like one of my favorite crowd reactions is that one dude just standing up and going like.
Yeah,
and
with
then,
the
like,
bracket
looking
reset.
Around.
Yeah. Your mind can't be blown that much. Come on. It was just like a Falcon downer. It was like, come on.
I think you get into it, right? Like it becomes more than just what you're watching. It's like the being part of the crowd makes you like.
Yeah, for sure. This guy was just like, it was really funny.
It was just ridiculous.
These are my options. I can either pay $20 for the balcony or dress circle, which I'm assuming is a shit spot because it's the cheapest option. Yeah,
balcony's
like,
awesome.
The balcony was pretty good.
The very outer edge.
Yeah, they had giant screen.
I think if you can get front row balcony, I think that's the best seat in the house.
That's what I'd prefer almost.
There's the floor, which is $30, the main center floor.
back part, and then the orchestra, which is like front seats, like right, like dead center front seats. That's $50.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's not terrible. Yeah, no, I'm telling you, the front row balcony for Smash is gonna be perfect. Like, there's you don't need to see the stage, you know? Like, there's no benefit.
Just because the screens the screens are just so big.
And actually, I think being up close, dude, that the sound was so loud.
Yeah, the bass was insane. It was just like, whoa.
I just like feel it through the headset the whole time. Like, Jesus.
Every time the electricity hits.
Dude, what was really bad is Link. Like, Link, for some reason, was so loud at SmashCon whenever he was like doing.
Oh, yeah. All of his sword sound effects. They're like really loud. Like,
oh my god. This character sounds like he's really good.
And Jimmy Joe and I were like, what the heck is going on over there?
Oh my god. Dude, the combo contest, I tried my hardest to just shitpost on Twitter as much as possible throughout all of it, but I didn't realize it was like multiple rounds, dude. I ran out of things to say.
Yeah.
No, it was awesome, and it would have been so much more awesome if Murray West hadn't...
If he hit his combo?
He just didn't taunt with his face.
Like, it just, he busted out his like top combo first. Yeah. It's like he had all these other ones where he could have just like, and they were awesome, and he could have just moved on.
I explained to some like Kansas or Missouri people this past week that like watched it but didn't really, they're not like really really into the scene yet, and they're like, oh yeah, I saw that. I'm like, did you know what he was going for? He's like, well, I saw he was going for like a taunt cancel or something like that. And I'm like, yeah, and then a Falcon kick, and they're like, oh my god. Like, that would have been the craziest combo in the world.
It wasn't just taunt cancel. He was using his face to hit the L button.
Well, you had to.
No, you don't.
He doesn't have a Hori.
Wait, how? How do you taunt cancel then with only...
Just use like your leg or something.
You're using the joystick to run over there. And then right when you get there, you move your right hand.
Yeah.
Prince
was able to taunt cancel, so... Marie has no excuse.
Yeah, but there was a delay. When he taunt canceled, you can see Falcon pause for a second because he went back to switch his hands back.
I
had time to do it.
I don't know,
if
guys. If
he practiced a little bit, he'd be able to do it pretty easily. I don't know how... Now, I don't know how short his window was for getting the taunt cancel and then starting the Falcon kick. Like, for it to connect. Yeah. It might have been, like, so short that was the only way he could do it.
Yeah. I saw him do the combo 3 times in a row when he was warming up, though. I was like, yeah, he's got it in the bag. And then,
or that Pikachu one he was doing with the fastball single hit fair.
Yeah, I've seen that. Yeah, that's from his, he has like different Pikachu.
Yeah, he did it like 3 times
combo
in a row.
That's from like his third one. He has like Pikachu combos for beginners, and then it's like Pikachu combos for amateurs, and then it's like advanced Mariguas combos.
And
I'm just
If they're the next combo contest, like, it could have Marigus, it could have Prince, it could have Janitor, it could have Pete. It could, I don't know who else is like really well known for combos.
Good job.
Hero Pie would just do his damn
combos. Dexter did all right.
He did better than I thought he was going to do.
Tacos had absolutely nothing planned. He just got up there and like made stuff up.
Yeah, I thought that was funny.
That was kind of annoying.
I think Hero Pie could actually have better combos than Janitor if he practiced. That's the sad part, but he just doesn't practice. Crazy. Yeah.
D-Tan brings up a good point. It's either D-Tan or Ryan, one of the Colorado brothers. Says that he really liked Alvin. He said that Alvin did the best variation to the gym combo he's ever seen. So I think... What do you mean, what's the gym combo?
I want to see Zeeb's combos. Nobody did one. That was disappointing.
Yeah, I wanted that, like, off the lava.
Yeah.
I wanted that to happen.
Or maybe, like, an elevator combo or something. That stage is, I want to do something.
Or like something on Saffron with the Pokemon, like...
Whoa. Or the warp pipe. The warp pipe combo with Prince.
Dude, that stage would have collapsed if somebody did, like, a 20-hit combo into an Electrode. The stage would have collapsed. Like, that building would have been...
That... I didn't even think about that. Like, my god.
Well, so, since this training mode, isn't it always the same Pokemon that come out in the same order every time?
Charmander.
Yeah. I think so.
So, I wonder how long you'd have to wait for an Electrode to come out.
Oh my god.
Like, make it work with, like crazy items. Like,
or, like, a Falcon, like, up air tipper, into like the electrode exploding, like
is there
something
a,
like that.
Is there a Game Shark for choosing your Pokemon?
Combo Blade seems to think that the Pokemon that comes out is random, so that could be really tough for a combo contest. If it's random.
But if he did get it into an Electrode, that'd be like...
Yeah. Maybe if he used the next version of NX6, maybe put in a code.
Well, or what if you just had an option for every Pokemon? It's like, well, if this one comes out, then I'll finish by doing this. And if this one comes out, I'll finish that.
And then you get a chancy.
Yeah, well, you'd use that to heal up your opponent 5% so that the next combo works. If they didn't reduce their 5%, then it wouldn't work.
But yeah, like now that it's a thing, now that the combo contest is a thing, I think some people are gonna really prepare for it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know Janitor's gonna have some crazy stuff.
So what you're trying to say is you're gonna have some really easy brackets coming up as everyone focuses on the entirely wrong thing.
Hey man, just don't play them on Peaches with items and it'll be okay. No, like I want to see more stuff with items. I think that'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, that was really sick.
I had some good ideas with that. I thought it was cool.
That was pretty hype with that bomb boss.
Yeah.
Did you just go for that?
Because like it was a totally like basic combo. It just ended with the bomb.
Yeah. That was cool.
Dude, somebody should just go up to the combo contest, be Mario, stand next to the opponent, drop down 4 green shells, and just down B him.
Yeah,
be like, you guys ever seen a combo like this before?
Or someone gets like 2 links and then pull out the
the black hole.
Bomb glitch and then combo them into the black hole.
Or just do a Fox weak up air to home run bat.
Ooh, that'd actually be really, really funny to just like any combo at all, just ending with something that just always kills.
Yeah. I mean, I was just gonna go Falcon and push Pikachu to the ledge and do forward throw, forward air up B.
Oh, that'd be really funny.
There's a lot of potential in this you know this competition of combos.
Yeah, there's just so much you can do with like all the different stages, all the different characters, items. Like it could be pretty cool. Can you adjust the damage ratio in training mode?
I don't. Only with a Game Shark would probably.
Okay, because I know you can do it in versus mode. I didn't know if you could do it in training mode.
Yeah, there's no default option that lets you do that.
Cause that'd be crazy if you just like cranked it down so you could make the combo like 3 times longer.
Or what if like someone handicapped themselves and put the camera like zoomed in up close so nobody could see what the hell was going on, but they just kept the combo going?
That'd actually be really impressive.
I like that a lot, especially if you set up like a bomb trick or whatever, so that you like obviously couldn't see something that required strict timing, but then you still comboed them into it. I think
yeah,
that'd be really.
To, like, go to the menu, like,
yeah, show it.
Back and then, like,
it'd be great if you sent him over to the bomb, and then the bomb sent it back towards you, and you hit him. So it's like people would have to infer what happened, but they'd be like, "Oh my god, like, no way."
I want to see stuff with bumpers.
Dude, I love bumpers.
Yeah, bumpers are cool.
Go for the 908.
Oh my god.
You guys don't know about the 908?
Maybe like a red shell or something. I know like red shell allows for a lot of shenanigans. I've gotten like comboed by a red shell against the wall. It was.
Oh yeah, really? Yeah, just bounce you off the wall.
Dude. Someone combo says, I think Boom would have done a standard Kirby combo if he was made to do it.
He just goes up tilt, up tilt, up tilt, up tilt, and then like
hi,
and then like up air, like landing on the platform, and then like FB.
Dude, what were we talking about? ZB's during this, ZB's. Acid always down. Legal or not legal?
No.
You guys wouldn't legalize that? Why not?
It'd be like it'd be so awful for camping. Like some characters like they can't get to the platform on the left.
Oh yeah, Kirby would be broken.
like without using your up B. So like you have to. Yeah, it'd be awful.
The thing about how hard it would be to approach a Kirby standing in the little pit, like that.
All right.
That too.
You guys convinced me.
It's like so you have like
that was easy.
You have the Yoshi's. You have the Yoshi's Island level where like, you know, it has like the really high platforms like that. But yeah. The 19X
Jason,
version,
you already convinced me.
No.
Listen what he's saying.
So in the when you play versus mode, mm-hmm. Yoshi's Story, the platforms are really high.
Oh, you're saying like, get like a version of it that it's more.
When you play the one player mode, it's like squished down. But that's because that stage already exists that way because of one player mode.
Yeah.
But it makes it not nearly as bad because the platforms are like accessible to every character.
And every character has platform like.
Every character has perfect lands.
I love Yoshi's Story. That is my favorite. Is it Yoshi's Story or Yoshi Island? Whatever.
It's Island. Island. Stories of Melee.
Why does it have the book then? I don't. Whatever. it's like my favorite. I think that might be my favorite stage in the game right now.
The 19XX version.
Yeah, and even more than Dreamland. I think it's.
Yeah. No, I just meant like as opposed to the normal one with the clouds.
Yeah. 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 The 19XX version.
No, it's a
no,
really
I love
cool
the one
stage.
With the clouds. I just go to the side and go pew 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 pew.
You would. Yeah.
Yeah.
Not surprised. No, I like the 19XX version. People are like, oh, but the blast zones, like okay.
Oh wow, so it's unique and allows different like strategies and.
Yeah. Like. The issue that I find that I have with that one is that the stage dips in the middle.
Once again, Kirby just wants to fight there, probably.
I don't know. I guess it's not that big. It's not as bad as like the ledge on Hyrule where Kirby can actually like sit behind it.
Yeah, it's just different. I don't know. It would require a lot of testing to figure out if it's really bad for like it's really good for a character. I bet Ness is really good on that stage.
Just every single character can die quickly. So, like, recovery isn't as important.
Right.
And getting hit by like, a Link up tilt is scary.
Yeah.
It's actually scary. Yeah.
Yeah. Ness is good. Link's
I really
good.
Like that stage. Yeah. As far as the 19XX stages, the one I could see never being legal is Metal Cavern.
Really?
People are going to ban FD because they don't like that it has no platforms before they'll... ban Metal Cavern, even though it's too small to be viable for a lot of characters.
So easy to edgeguard FD.
Metal Cavern, it's just like I like it, but it's so small and it.
I like the crook. I like that a lot because if you're on top, it's whoever sets up on that first has like can do some cool things on it. Because if you're like so like Fox's down tilt, if you're on the flat part of it, and someone's down here, you can like hit him right in the face with your tail.
Right, because it like angles up.
Well, yeah, if you're on the top part. And if you're on the bottom part, then it does angle up, and then it can hit him in the face. So I like it a lot.
Just the fact that the stage is so small, I think.
I think it's that it's small and that when you, at least for me, like if you're on the left side as Fox, you have to do a frame-perfect input in order, at least I think it's frame-perfect, in order to jump to the platform. So even if you've already recovered to the stage, you're still screwed. You still don't have any options.
Oh, because you can't jump to the platform.
Right. So it's, like, really rough. But...
And you said Fox has a hard time jumping to the platform?
Yeah.
So that means no one can do it.
That's what I imagine.
Second jump is, like, stupid high.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I've only gotten it, like, five or six times. So I don't know.
Well, I mean, that's... So, like, Pikachu, I think... is still really good on Metal Cavern, but, like, recovery options, they don't have, like... all these different places they can go.
Yeah.
I mean, they can try Wario, but...
It's a lot easier to read the recovery. But again, the stage is just so small. That's my issue with it.
I hope that one day we have a legal stage with an angled platform, so somebody will develop drop canceling and blow everyone's minds.
Yeah.
Really, we just need to legalize Metal Cavern for doubles.
Yeah. I'd do it. I actually would not
it's
do that. That
fun.
Would destroy me.
We play like four DKs on Metal Cavern. There's just no room for anything.
Dude, the tiny semblance.
If you just up B at any time, you'll hit something.
That's. Dude, the tiny semblance of viability I have, it would just be destroyed by Metal Cavern doubles.
But no, I really like Yoshi's Battlefields. Kind of cool. It's weird getting used to the higher platforms,
mm-hmm.
which screws over a lot of characters.
Yeah, it's just a totally different. I mean, it's a different stage.
Yeah, FD is kind of weird. It just, I don't know.
I don't know how to feel about FD. I think FD and doubles would be really good.
I think FD needs a little more. You know, I don't think there's that many issues with balance, because as everyone thought there were a few with like lack of platforms. We just need more testing after we fix the spawns. That's it.
Yeah, you just have to enforce
control. Yeah, well, I mean, it's very easy to just be like, okay, let's run to the sides before we start.
Woo, yeah. Special guest.
Uh-huh. No guests allowed, sorry.
Yay. That's not even the right ear. Stick it in there.
What's up, Seto?
There we go. Yay.
What's up, Chodes?
Yeah.
Wow. Soda, how'd you do at SmashCon?
How did I do? I just did. I didn't do that well. Yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't do well, nor I did great.
He don't know how it is, but he do.
It is what it is.
So that means 49th, or?
Yeah, I think that's what ended up.
Yeah,
I have it pulled up.
Yeah.
I wasn't just interpreting blindly on that one. Yeah. No, dude, how'd you let a Wookiee beat you?
I don't think he's beat me yet.
I outplaced him.
Mm.
Yeah, you mean, yeah. Poor
Yo, how, you
poor
guys
Fraser.
Teamed, right? You teamed for doubles?
Yeah. We beat the shit out of Fire Blaster.
Oh, yeah?
Wow.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And then we look, and they're in top eight, and we're like, what?
You guys had an incredible loser run.
That's what I felt. Damn. I really wanted to play your team, Fire.
Yeah.
Who did you team with?
You just go double Kirby, and you win. That's all it is.
Right?
I team for Shalaka.
I don't know how we lost to Revan and Shear, but I really wanted to play you guys.
Nobody knows how they lost to who they lost to.
Yeah.
I know how I lost to. I know exactly how I lost to. I lost to Fyro and Nintendude because they're better than.
We just couldn't
figure
out how to beat them, and that's how we lost.
Because they're better than me and Ian.
No, both sets that we lost, we were up, and then the next thing I knew, we lost.
There's another upset I just remembered. Studstill beating Shears. In one set for doubles.
Yes, the doubles.
Never forget.
Studstill and Nest Khalifa beat Shears and Daniel in the winner's side, and then on the loser's side to make it out, Shears and Daniel won against Studstill and
but
Nest Khalifa.
Studstill still beat Shears. So.
Oh, yeah, they still won.
Yeah.
It's just funny that they got their rematch.
How did you guys do so well in doubles, Dark?
I'm excited for more doubles. Like, doubles getting more popular and everything.
Yeah.
Oh, so what you're saying is you're excited for Star King's rule set?
No.
I mean, not really. Like, people hate on Pika Kirby. Like, I have fun playing Kirby. Like, I like some of the Kirby things.
Kirby Luigi is gonna be the truth.
I want to see.
And then Mark doesn't play anyone other than Pika, so like.
I like that. I like that everyone has said a different. Everyone's like has said different things. Bark alone has said six different character combinations are going to be the number one thing.
Yep.
Like you're saying, Luigi Kirby jokingly.
Like, if you get rid of Pika Kirby, now like, so now basically every team has a Pika. So
I wouldn't.
Like, okay. So. Yeah,
I would still do. Yeah, I would do Kirby Fox.
Well, we know.
Just don't play Fox in doubles. just don't.
Fox and doubles is rough.
I would rather play my skill level of Fox than your skill level of PK and doubles.
The only good doubles team of Fox is me and Han Solo, and no one's going to replicate what we did again. So.
Where'd you guys go? 0-2 or?
No.
No, they did well.
We got.
They did well. At Snoza won.
Yeah, we got like fifth, I think, at Snoza for doubles.
Yeah, I think it might. Been fifth or
we got we got eliminated by Mariguas and Nier and Team Mayhor, I think.
Oh, okay.
I will say that Han Solo is like the one person who I don't like. My general rule for like firing shots or like talking trash is like I either know you, like I've talked to you in person, or like I've heard your voice and you've heard my voice, like either that or I'm about to, like, oh, this person's coming out this week, or let's talk a little bit of trash. And then, like, the other people that I've done that to, I feel bad about. But the one person I don't feel bad about doing it to is Han Solo. So
I just felt bad about gimping as Fox because it was just making him want to quit more. I was just like, I'm so sorry.
Dude.
You weren't that sorry.
Yeah, I had a smirk. It was fun. But he's moving to NorCal now. NorCal is just getting players. It's just everyone's moving to NorCal for some reason.
And half of them play Fox.
Wait, is he back into the scene?
He told me when we talked last he would only play tournaments that were like local, and now NorCal has a fuck ton of tournaments, so I would assume he would. Yeah. I hope.
So what, there's Han Solo, Nintendo.
There's players that have moved there. Han Solo, Nintendo, Egg Mode apparently is Egg Mode apparently is moving to NorCal. Bard, and then
Who's Bard?
Did Hipster move there?
No, Hipster's going somewhere else.
Bard's our number 8 or 9. Bard's our number 9 here.
Oh, Dark Horse, you're thinking of Hipster lived in
Reno.
Yeah.
Okay, I just know he goes to the NorCal tournaments.
Yeah, cuz he's on the NorCal PR, so.
I think he's moving though. As the
I thought I heard someone say that on the stream last
night. It makes sense, yeah.
Yeah,
NorCal's top tiers are all going to be people that move there.
Is that the whole End is Nair series? Is that a monthly series?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then they still have like weeklies at the Foundry and everything, which the Foundry is the best venue in Smash, period. There's no arguing. It's just is. So it's pretty cool.
What's so good about it?
It's a brewery and it's like an esports arena also, and they just They just have a shit ton of money that just gets funneled in everything, so it's like the nicest computers, like the nicest monitors.
Why do they have so
the
much money?
Everything. It's San Francisco. That's all. Just everyone has money, so it's like, oh yeah, here, you guys want $1 million for video games? Here you go.
Okay.
Like all legitimately. Right. Like that's pretty much how it went, I'm sure.
Alternatively, I think we're getting Cobra early next year.
Yeah, Cobra's moving to SoCal.
Are you serious?
Really?
Yeah, and Dexter has expressed interest in moving here, and Bonze even said he might be moving to the U.S., but he's not sure where.
I love Bonze.
Jimmy Joe has talked about moving to
SoCal.
Well,
Lorenzo's in Texas right now, and Core's moving to New York at some point.
Yeah.
So what's our...
New Jersey, holy crap. New Jersey, 2 or 3 years ago, you see like the most popular place for Smash 64, and now it's dead.
The way it should be.
It's because Rob doesn't foster.
He was like the haven for 64, and then now that we're all active, like nothing happens in New Jersey.
Who's in there?
Yeah, the only thing that happened in New Jersey was me bringing Brazil over there, with like no one actually from New Jersey there.
The New Jersey tournament. I was there. That was a lot of fun.
Wasn't there a tournament in Texas today? Sorry, Capos. Wasn't there a tournament in Texas today? I saw CTG streaming.
There might have been. I don't know.
But like, because Lorenzo.
They don't really advertise anything.
No, weren't they at Show Me Your Moves?
Lorenzo's in Austin right now.
Yeah, he is.
I don't know how. I mean, it's Texas, so Austin could be like 8 hours away from where they are.
CTG was at Show Me Your Moves, though, I thought.
Yeah, he's been traveling a lot for work, I know.
Because I know Dogs Johnson beat him. Let's go, Dogs Johnson. Dude, Dogs Johnson's on the come up, man. I'm telling you guys listen to me right now. He's not on Colorado's level, but Dogs Johnson is getting good. And you guys are going to have to, if you guys are not paying attention.
A couple of right shots, don't overuse it.
What?
You've had a couple of good predictions, you know.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You should listen to my predictions. My predictions have been accurate. How many percent of the time? 100% of the time? Have I ever made a bad prediction?
I don't know.
Name a time I haven't made a good prediction. Dogs Johnson is getting good. He is on the come up. He's improving. What did you say?
I said, you saying you're good.
I think I demonstrated. And I didn't say I was good. I didn't say anything about me.
I think most of the time he just said he was better than we thought he was.
Which is true.
He was who we thought he was.
Thank you. Thank you, Dark Horse. I was better than you guys thought I was.
I know. I had to bust out a character. I hadn't played in a tournament in like a year.
Bark Sanchez thinking Dogs Johnson might be the second best in Midwest soon behind Combo. No. Wrong.
No.
Dogs Johnson has a ways to go before he can beat me. But Dogs Johnson is like DIing lasers on me now. He's doing all sorts of stuff. He has an awful Pikachu. He SD'd 4 times when he went Pikachu against me. No, Dogs is going to be good. You guys just wait.
Okay.
Good. How many times have you beaten Bonze, Jim? None. I've never played Bonze. All right.
So zero.
We're currently 0-0. We're tied.
That was the best. Dogs Johnson beating Bonze in the money match.
Dude, that was so funny. Dude, if you look at, he made a post on Indy that was like I made, like, I did a ton of money matches. Here's all the people I played. Like, I played this person, I played this person, played this person. And then there's like a really subtle, like, Bonze 3-2. Like, right in the middle. It's not like, guys, I beat Bonze 3-2. It's just like, this is what I did. This is the order I did it in. I'm like, dude, yeah, that's a pretty good win.
So, yeah, because, like, Bonze just sat down and just, like, played a whole bunch of people in money matches, just, like, one after the other. Ooh. After the other. And Dogs was the only one that won.
Dude, Dogs. Huh. Dogs Johnson. Dogs Johnson's, I'm telling you, he's getting good.
Yeah, after I played Bonze a few times, like, he started having a lot of trouble with my Falcon when I would just kind of, like, sit there and not do anything.
Wait, what?
He was like, you're so weird. You're so weird. Stop playing so weird. I guess he's probably, like, used to playing Court, who, like, will just, like, run in every single time.
Yeah.
Oh, Isaiah on Brazil and the, my God. Isaiah took 21 stocks from Brazil. That was just dumb.
In Isaiah's words, he reverse gangbanged them.
Yes, he reverse gangbanged Brazil. I don't even know what that is, but
I think it's when one person takes on several.
When one person bangs everyone.
As opposed to the other way around.
Okay, that makes more sense now. Yeah, he took 21 stocks off Brazil. That was insane.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Too bad.
I think he still had two socks. I think he had two socks left, so.
Yeah, it's too bad you guys couldn't beat
Mexico. Yeah,
Mexico
with Alvin, yeah.
Because then we had to play them.
Dude, that was such a... Mexico totally fucked up that whole bracket.
Yeah. Well, like...
Because they went Samus against you guys with, like, oh, but one person didn't go Samus. It's like, okay, yeah, great point. Thanks a lot, guys. Like.
Yeah, well, the one person was Alvin.
Yeah.
Who went Pikachu.
That's fine.
And so we thought they were all going Samus. So we're like, oh, we'll just put LD in first, because why not? They're all going Samus.
Yeah.
And then Alvin goes Pika. And yeah. So Alvin takes out LD, he takes out Daniel, and then he takes out most of Shears,
yeah.
I think. Or the other way around. Takes out LD, takes out Shears, takes out most of Daniel, and then Dexter comes up, and I think Daniel took like one or two stocks, and then lost. So then it was me and Bark against Dexter, Jaime, Mariguas, and Tacos. Granted, they were all playing Samus, but it was all four of them. But then we won. Because they suck.
That's like, yeah. What a fraudulent crew battle. Because they were clearly the best team.
Oh, well, obviously, yeah.
But now, anytime this gets brought up, I'm going to have to hear from someone that's like, well, Baltimore won the crew battle, so clearly we're the strongest team.
The only person that will say that and be serious is Shears.
Yeah. I really think that, I think Colorado would have won if Mexico wasn't there.
I think Colorado would have won if they were better and had better players.
I think they would have kicked your guys' ass.
And then they also... There's no way.
They wouldn't have beaten us.
Yeah, they wouldn't
just
have
because
beaten...
Because of Isaiah.
Yeah, they wouldn't have beaten California. They wouldn't have beaten us.
They
wouldn't have beaten Brazil.
They would have destroyed... They would have beat... Who was... They would have beaten Brazil. Their weakest player is good
Bonze,
enough.
Bonze, Court, Lorenzo, Rossi, and Jason.
Rossi... That's Lorenzo's as good as Mad Rush.
Yeah.
It's hard to, like...
Yeah, they're different characters. Yeah, I know. I understand. But...
Yeah, no.
That's Mad Rush.
We're happy to play Colorado in a crew battle. But...
Mad Rush is their fourth out of five. Lorenzo is their three out of five. Bonze's better
Rush
than...
Mad Rush lost to Studstill.
What?
I said Mad Rush lost to Studstill.
That's really funny.
Mad Rush is...
Dude, I love
he's
Raph.
He's just the guy that takes one for the team.
Dude,
know?
Raph
someone
does...
has to lose and Mad Rush just... He's that guy. He just needs to do it.
His Rap. Loss to me is forever immortalized in a framed photo.
This is true.
What? That's really funny. I think D-Tan took like 15 stocks or something like that from
New York.
Yeah.
Well, like Fyro went Kirby.
I think he five-stocked Fyro and Jimmy Joe.
He didn't five-stock Fyro. It was close.
What did
he
do?
Five-stocked Jimmy Joe. Fyro went Kirby. It made no sense. He should have just gone Ness or something. Like, the character he's really good with.
Yeah, I don't think it would have... I mean, yeah, he would have done better, I think, but I think Kirby Ditto's getting that, like, that stocked is...
Combo Play said he JV6 someone from Colorado and Falcon Ditto's.
Dude, that's... Yeah, that's definitely... That was definitely Luke, I bet.
Speaking of SmashCon and JV6's,
Oh. Dude, we have a rule about JV6s where I'm from, but it's never happened, so we haven't had to enforce it. But I'm...
Dude, Fireblaster, that was one of the best things that's like ever happened.
That's pretty rough,
him.
Dude.
You beat him in game two. You three-stocked him, and we're all going nuts. We're like, oh my god, like, Fireblaster's about to beat Alvin. And then that happened.
Then the six stock.
I forgot to play that matchup.
You missed everything. Like, you just missed things.
No, but I played that matchup completely wrong, too. Like, that wasn't, like, I wasn't supposed to go out there. I wasn't supposed to leave a certain spot on the stage, and I did, which caused me to lose.
Dude, I hate that.
Just nothing you did worked. Like, at one point, he was on the ledge, hanging on the ledge, and you walked over the ledge, and you were, like, up tilting, and he got up, did a regular ledge get up, and just up smashed you in between your up tilts, and then killed you. It's like, there's nothing was working.
Dude, that's so... I hate it so much when you...
I was partially on tilt because I think I saw, like, Mariguas or another one of the Mexicans, like, before the match, he went over to, like, whisper something to Alvin to give him advice against me. So I was...
Get coached!
That they were coaching him or against me, like, I don't know.
Javi, you should have called me over. I would have coached you.
I wasn't playing my best there.
I would have coached Alvin.
You were the only Pikachu that took a game off of him.
What?
Or sorry, you were the only one that. Yeah. No, never mind. I don't know why I was thinking the other way around. So he lost. He only lost to Yoshi's. Those are the only games he dropped the whole tournament.
I think so.
Because I don't. He won everything 2-0 except the ones, except yours and the ones he lost. I think. So you're one of three people that took a game off of him.
So good job. Cool. So congrats on getting JV sixth. Pretty fucking rough, dude. I'm sorry.
That like the three recorded JV sixes in tournaments have all been Peruvians.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind
of
crazy.
I'm already used to like being the butt end of these famous moments or these GP cats, because back when I was terrible and playing as Mutant King, I would like, he would do something like 4 baggers in a row because my DI was complete, like my DI was wrong, so I DI'd into his baggers over and over, and somebody would post like Mutant King does a like, you know, a combo in 64, and it was me, like
oh.
So I'm already used to
King
that.
Doesn't do combos, but...
So I'm already used to that.
Oh god, did anyone watch the Smash Masters thing?
No, I didn't get to see it.
YouTube Nintendo was painful because there was no timer.
Why wasn't there a timer?
Nintendo almost lost because he was just camping the whole time.
Dude, I played Mewtwo King without a timer, and it was rough.
And Wizrobe almost JV6 ESAM.
That's really funny.
I think Esam got one hit. It was a double Look. 5-stock, pretty sure. He just destroyed him. It was awesome.
That's yeah. That's funny. Who won that, Mewtwo King? Overall,
yeah.
I mean.
Yeah, overall, yeah. It was Mewtwo King and Wizrobe, I believe, in the finals.
Okay. So no upsets.
Like, it was close. I think Wizrobe like almost was able to pull out Melee. And if Wizrobe had won Melee, he would have won the whole thing.
Yeah, that
like,
makes
that
sense.
That was it. He had to win Melee, but he didn't.
Because Wizzy's good at 4, but I don't think he's as good as M2K is.
Yeah, Mewtwo King's like really good at 4. And Brawl.
Yeah.
And Wizrobe...
I don't think Wizrobe had a chance at Brawl, but...
No, like I think Mewtwo King like auto-win Brawl, and Wizzy auto-win 64.
Yeah.
Like, the big toss-up was Melee.
But like, if Wizzy had the bigger victory, like, Wizzy easily had the biggest victory in 64, which is like the tournament rules. Like, if you have a big victory, that counts more or something.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, so they played all 4 games, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that was a tiebreaker, because if 2 people won, like, 2 games each, then whoever had more big victories would count with.
Right. Win.
So I think JV whatever stocking Mewtwo King was pretty big. Like Mewtwo King's not gonna do that to Wizrobe in Melee or
Smash 4. Or yeah, in any game. It's funny. Smash 4, like, he could 2-stock him. It happens.
Don't even talk about Smash 4.
Does that even count as a big victory?
I don't, like... It's weird, because, like, those matches could drag on forever, but you can also, like, get a weird gimp against some characters and just, like, take a stock really quick.
Yeah, I saw one game go 16 seconds, just because, like... I was like, are you, the fact that this is even possible is just dumb.
I think that what happened at SmashCon was like, he took it against the Luigi and he just got up and left. He got like, because Luigi's not being that game.
Oh, spikes, right.
Yeah. He spikes you, yeah, so.
Yeah, yeah, it was something like that.
Yeah,
was
just he, like, got, this he got destroyed stupid. And he just got up and left.
Yeah.
I think, I'm trying to think of my fastest game. I beat Cheers once in under a minute in one game.
Pretty good.
That's pretty good. Shit.
Yeah, a minute victory is that's a stock every 12 seconds.
I mean, I could see that happening in like matchups where someone can just get gimped.
Yeah, against Pikachu is kind of hard.
Yeah, that's what was so funny.
Did he SD? How many times did he SD?
Zero. He just got comboed because he didn't see
standard combo every time.
He's dang.
You lose every set of shine due to an SD?
Probably.
If you ask him, he won't remember.
Yeah, he was just so...
I mean, fortunately...
Hungover. Hungover.
I mean, it's pretty cool, though, that, like, he was able to place higher than he ever did at that tournament.
I mean, it was pretty easy to place high at that tournament, though.
Wait, what?
Like, outside of, like, the top, like, 5 or 6 people.
Nobody.
Like,
I mean, all you had to do was play, was get top 8, and you were, like, automatically placed high.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, he plays really high.
Very high. Very high indeed.
And it's pretty awesome that afterwards, after the tournament, that the interview was like a pretty high priority for everybody.
Yeah. Yeah, they blazed through it pretty quick though, so.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Jim. Don't worry.
Jim.
That tournament was a blast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've gathered what happened.
You fell asleep again.
The Cheers pictures, though, that created the memes on 64L was like the greatest thing that could ever happen to my life. Because I have them forever now, so. Cheers is fucked.
So
the tiger picture.
Watch out, cougars! It's hunting season.
And not even the heart one. It's pretty amazing.
Yeah, the heart one's good.
All right,
yeah, that might be the best meme I ever make though. So I've accepted it. It's fine.
That's your G3 salty suite right there.
That is my G3 salty suite. G3 salty suite trailer. That is it.
Nothing I ever do will be better. My whole life.
Alright guys, we can either really dive more into this stuff or we can just probably call it a night.
I'm kind of hungry. I need dinner, so.
Alright. Well, let's just do a quick plug for things besides all the Twitters that you can see at the bottom. The only weird one is Wookiees is LAS tournaments. Upcoming tournaments, ODS. It's going to be sick next week. Who cares for a month? Something. Boss Battle 2 is November 12th.
Super Boom.
Super Boom.
Oh, that's October?
Yeah.
Just kidding,
yeah,
guys.
That's kind of a big deal.
Super Boom. These are like our last big 3 tournaments of the year.
Yeah, I mean, nothing's been announced for December, but like, who knows?
Maybe Hitsun 4.
Was Hitsun? Yeah, Hitsun was in November.
Hitsun was
December
last year. It was on
so,
my birthday.
The overnight tournament.
I will say that Boss Battle 2 is going to be the last tournament of the year that is going to be let's just say that if you care about how well you did in 2016, you should come out to one of these 3 tournaments, because those are going to be your last big tournaments.
Boffo is definitely going to be the last big one of the year, because even if Hitsun happens, I think there's going to be like some serious travel fatigue between like Super Boomed and then Boss Battle for Hitsun to get really big.
Yeah, and then Genesis is the next month, so.
Oh, yeah, there's also that Seattle tournament in December.
Go park in the grass
too. Yeah, don't park in the grass.
So,
it's a good problem.
There's more, you know, things are in the works, but I'm just saying that if you care about how people think of you, you should come out to one of these three.
It's a rough life.
It's not that many tournaments. I mean, our major tournaments are 2 a year, and we have some, I think we have 3.
We went from 2 to 3 to, I lost sound.
No, no, okay, so listen, we got 2 majors.
Okay. 2 super majors.
Whatever you want to call it, I don't care. You have 3 exclusive for N60, or for, yeah, for 64 tournaments. You have ODS, you have Boss Battle 2, something else. Snowza, that's the one. Yeah. Sorry, dude.
Not a big deal.
And then you have a lot of like smaller but big tournaments like Apex and basically ones that are like major tournaments.
I mean,
for
how many entries did Apex have?
55, I think. 56.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I
right.
I thought it had like
I think
100.
Shine had like 100, I think. I don't know.
Shine had
more than
either
pound,
just over or just under what Pound had.
No, which had was
more. Okay. So it was, yeah, it was over 100.
Yeah, so then you have those two, which are like, they're big, but they might be big because of other games having some cross. Like, they're big tournaments as they stand, right?
Yeah.
They're not
China,
big.
Shine and Pound were big because they're on the East Coast.
Yeah.
They're big tournaments.
So that's kind of it.
They also are multi-game, like, East Coast has all the multi-game, like, national tournaments that happened to F64.
And the only reason Apex was small was because Snowsa was the same day.
Yeah, literally,
yeah.
Literally,
that's the only reason.
Well, yeah.
Well, 2 reasons.
Yeah, there's other reasons that Apex.
I mean, like, you can blame all the other stuff, but the real reason it was small is because Snowsa was that weekend.
Yeah, there was just a lot of people that flew in.
I think there was a lot of people who were, like, afraid to go anyways.
Yeah.
A lot of people warned me not to go, and I'm like, whatever.
I think Apex would have been the size of Shine and Pound. Or slightly smaller. What? Even with Snowsa, it wouldn't have been as prestigious for our community because of that. Because you
Apex
know.
Would have gotten at least 100 people if Snowsa had been a different day.
Like we had more. Like 64 still had like some of the most entrants above other games that weren't Melee, in Smash 4. It had more than Street Fighter 5. It had more than all like the 2D like the FGC games.
Mm.
It had more than those games in 2015 though, I think.
What? Mm.
Yeah,
64 for a while has had like more games than the other FGC games.
Those other games, the turnout is surprisingly low.
Because they have Capcom Cup and stuff, right?
Yeah, but I'm still surprised because this time it was Beef with Techie running it. He's been in a long time FGC stream.
Hmm, that's true.
So,
good point.
Like,
can't wait to see Fire Blaster playing Street Fighter V at Evo next year.
I might go to Evo just for fun though, because I've been wanting to go that one time. That event's ridiculous.
Dude, Street Fighter Top 8 was crazy this year. It was so fun. That'd be cool to be there.
Yeah.
Sorry, it's 64 at Evo next year.
Yeah, right. I think the only other big tournament was Gommel, right? I think that was pretty much it. So that's like, I'm pulling out my list of everything. But I think that's like a total of 10-ish tournaments that are like notable.
Yeah.
And if you really only care about the big ones, there's 5. And if you really only care about the big ones, there's 2.
Well, before we only had 1 regional and then 1 major, and that was it.
Yeah.
1 regional, 1 major. And then we went from that to what, 10? 12? Like,
that's true.
Yeah.
That's a big.
It's hard to go to everything. Like it used to be able to do.
Oh, very, yeah. It's a good problem to have, though. And there's more scenes popping up, like Fire Blaster, like your scene's kind of like popping up now.
Nintendo.
You're getting more players out there.
I just came to Kansas and there's a Kansas scene now.
What?
There's no one good in Kansas, I mean, besides me. Great player. But that's actually, there's a good player, just getting, forgot. There's a guy named Potts. He doesn't come out to things.
I know who Potts is. I've heard of him.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of that.
He used to play online. He's played. He beat. I think he got second place when the Cobros came out. So he beat everyone except for D Tan beat him. So, I mean, he'd get out of pools. Probably get 33rd with everyone else. But yeah, there's good players. Anyway, that's it. There's nothing else to talk about.
Cool.
I think we all agree that Four Stocks is what it should be, and Pika Kirby should be banned from doubles.
Totally.
So with that, I will see y'all later.
we'll talk about times that we can do this. If this is still a good time for us to, you know, since we've come back, we might choose another time. I know that people have had some issues with scheduling.
Yeah, and see we're gonna start having. Oh, that's another big thing for SoCal. We're in SSS, which is like the biggest biweekly ever. So we're gonna start being in that every other week after ODS.
That's awesome. So, SSS is awesome.
It'll be good.
That'd be sick. Cool. So I guess I will see you guys later. And oh yeah, I'm supposed to sign off. I totally forgot about this.
You can do it.
I actually don't remember what I was supposed to say. Oh yeah, Jason, tell me what I'm supposed to say.
No, you got it, man. You get it right every time.
Okay. Okay, I know it's something about the cat. Keep it, catch it, catch you. Is it catch you on the DL? Oh, I'll catch you on the DL.
My God.